Hey guys, here we go. We've got this is the week of iCast and this virtual iCast. Well, Tom's over on the other side. I'm not happy with the virtual iCast, but that's a whole nother story. We'll get into that later on. This is we're going to talk to Tom. He's from Freedom Tackle Corporation, and he has one of the most creative lures that is coming out this year. The Mischief Minnow. I know everyone's already been asking me, when am I going to get one? When am I going to do a closer look? When they get available and they're ready to be on here, I will go out and buy one and do my closer look. But without further ado, let's welcome Tom. Well, how do you say your last name, Tom?
Chopin.
Tom Chopin from Freedom Tackle. So, hello. Let me hit the applause button. There you go. Thank you.
My pleasure.
How are you today, man?
Well, I'm kind of glad I'm not in that Florida 98-degree, 100% humidity weather, but I'm up in Canada. We've actually been having our own 90-degree weather for like the last 3 weeks, so we've had that iCast weather up here already, so we didn't get to miss it this year.
So tell me a little bit about yourself. How did you get into the industry? Well, first tell me how you started off, how you got introduced into the outdoors.
I've always been an avid angler. My dad was a hunter and a fisherman, and we always went to cottages as kids. And my grandma had a pond just full of bluegills, and we could catch them with a piece of gum or whatever we could find to put on a hook. You catch a bluegill. So I fished my whole life, and about 11 years ago, I made a jump from the financial business, and I joined Live Target when it first started up. And I spent about 7 years there and came over to Freedom Tackle about 4 years ago. And then this past year, we've had a big partnership with American Baitworks. Yep. And joined a group. Yep. Of companies. So it's been a pretty exciting year since last iCast. So
yeah.
Very, very busy.
Yeah. Yeah. When you look at what you had last year and being down here, I mean, you talked about the weather, but what's the overall thought thing about how this year and COVID, how much has it changed y'all's lives up there?
It hasn't changed us too much. I'm actually hearing a lot more, like, the independent retailers are doing really, really well. There seems to be a lot more people having staycations and taking the kids fishing into the lake, into the ponds and stuff like that. So I've actually, seems like fishing is on a bit of an uptick here. Our province in Ontario actually just did the last 2 weeks. You didn't need a fishing license at all. So it actually helped promote people getting in the outdoors, but still keeping your social distancing. So
one of the lures that people have been asking me nonstop is, Steve, when are you going to do a closer look? I do these closer look videos where I take the video and do 360 and I go fish with it and tell it. But since people have seen the Mischief Minnow, it's been one that people have been requesting nonstop. Tell us about this fantastic lure that is just completely different than anything I've ever seen.
Well, this is probably the biggest launch that Freedom Tackle has had. And we did a lot of some really great marketing videos. And I think that's what's really grabbing a lot of attention. It's a product when you look at it, it looks good. But once you see the video and you hear it in the video, then everybody's like, oh my God, like I need that. I need to see that. Tell me more about that. So it's pretty exciting right now.
How long was the process to create this? Who started it and whose idea was it? I mean, how long does that process take?
Yeah, Mike and Nick Timber are the owners of Freedom Tackle, and Mike is the lure tinkerer. He's an antique lure collector and always built his own baits for muskie and then started the whole swing hook technology with Freedom and the removable hook and just always tinkering and thinking. So we kind of want to branch into some other categories with Freedom, and this topwater idea came about, and Mike kind of ran with it. Probably about a year and a half we've been playing around with this. It's very different. We had to play around with weights to get it right and to get the actions right, and just a lot of little nuances. We see some people on social media going, oh, just take a jerk bait and throw a blade on it. It's not going to work.
Yeah.
This thing is so unique and has a lot of little attributes that make it very, very different.
So if you're, I put the little picture on my side so people don't see me as much. You have two sizes. It comes with 4.5 and 3.5 inches. It is, if you could explain to people that are looking at it that have never seen it before, how would you explain the lure?
I usually start off saying picture a three-hook jerkbait, and we've taken the middle hook off and put a blade in place on a little hanger, and we've taken the lip off, and we've made it float. So it's a topwater lure. It's not going to dive. It's not a jerkbait. It's actually a topwater lure, but it's kind of a hybrid between a buzzbait and a spook or something like that. So it's very, very unique. Do you want me to get into the details?
Yeah, please.
So I've got one here. I know you got the picture up in your thing. So if you look at that blade, we're calling that the kilter blade. So this is probably what took us the most time in creating. If you look at that blade, it's not symmetrical. It's round on one side, flat on the other. We've got some corners cut off. So what happens in the water is that blade turns and it hits the rear hook, it hits the body of the bait, and actually makes a really loud clack, 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 clack sound. So in the videos that we're showing on social media, it's not mic'd, it's not enhanced. That's the sound you get from this bait. So while that blade is hitting the body and the hook, we call it the kilter blade, because it's actually throwing the blade or the bait itself off kilter. So the bait is rolling body side to side, but then it also kind of hunts once in a while, so it kind of blows out. So you can fish this just straight retrieve, cast it out like you would a buzzbait, reel it back. You can catch fish, you can add pauses in there, you can snap it and jerk it. And when you do some little more aggressive stuff, the blade will actually spray up water. So we have a 5-minute video on our social media that actually shows a lot of those retrieves and the different actions you can get out of this bait. So it's going to be really, really great for guys that like schooling fish where they're busting the surface, because you can actually stop it mid-retrieve, like a buzzbait would sink. This you can just stop it, start it, just a lot of different attributes to it.
We had somebody ask a question. Andrew said, "Do you need to twitch it in, or can you reel it straight in?"
Yeah, you can just reel it straight in. It doesn't walk the dog like is there a spook type bait would. Mm-hmm. It's actually better on a retrieve and a pause and a twitch and a pull. So the novice angler can tie this on and fish it right out of the package without really knowing how to fish. You can just throw it out like a buzzbait and straight retrieve it.
Yeah, that's a good thing. The video I saw, the thing I liked the most about it was not only the sound, because it sounds a lot like, I don't know if you were going for this, it sounds like a chatterbait underwater, but it's almost like a topwater spook bait, even though you're not walking the dog, with the chatterbait sound.
Yeah.
But also you can work it many ways by straight retrieving or little stops and pauses. But also that, like you said earlier, that blade actually throws up a little bit of water, almost like it's a bait fish are there's extra bait fish chasing it or with it. Was that kind of the goal? Was it?
Yeah.
How often have you used it?
I used it all last year.
Yeah.
And had great success with it. Yeah. So it's why I love topwater fishing. And, down south, my very first experience in a southern lake on Table Rock, we were waking like a bomber long A for schooling bass, and anything that put a V on the surface was getting eaten that day.
Yeah.
And as soon as we did this, I went, oh my God, this would have been perfect that day. We would have just been crushing them on this bait, because it makes that V on the surface. And when the schooling fish see that V, they know they got a fish that they can, peg up against the surface of the water and eat it. So
now what kind of treble hooks are you using? What is the core of the treble hooks?
So these come with Gamagatsu short shank trebles.
Okay.
So the short shank keeps it away from the line tie and the blades. So just a real super strong hook and good catchability on it, which is important. We want to make it premium components.
Yeah.
A little different too. It has a horizontal line tie, so that helps a little bit with that action as well. You're not pulling it straight. Allows the bait to kind of hunt side to side. We do include a clip in the package, so if guys want to fish it with a clip, the clip makes it a little freer.
Mm-hmm.
Initially, I was fishing it on a loop knot, and a lot of times just tying it directly as well and getting good action out of it as well.
Yeah, it's a really great looking bait. How many colors is it going to come in?
It's going to be 15 colors in the two sizes. And like I said, we've got some of the natural baits are silver and gold blades. And then like this bait here, we got a chartreuse blade. Mm-hmm. The perch has an orange blade. So we've got some painted blades, natural, and some black nickel blades as well. So kind of different baits for different conditions.
And retail price, what is retail price going to be on them?
$9.99 and $10.99.
Oh, so you're right. It's a great price too.
Sorry, I apologize.
$11.99, $12.99 Still, now, when are these? Because I know we're at iCast. Well, technically iCast. Yeah. When are these available? When are these going to be available for people to go out and check out?
By the end of the month.
They're excellent.
Already. Yeah, they're available for pre-order at Taco Warehouse and on the American Baitworks website already. But within the next 2 weeks, they're going to be out there, and we've already got lots of pre-orders, so it's pretty exciting.
Yeah, there's been a lot of buzz on this bait. There's been, you know, we kind of go through these ups and downs. Sometimes we get these buzzes, and then other times we don't. But this has been one of the lures that our followers and listeners have been saying, Steve, you got to get this. You got to do a closer look. So I'm looking forward to getting out. I'll go pre-order some. I'm looking forward to the smaller one, to be honest, because I think that'll match the hatch of some of these smaller bait fish that we have running around right now. So
I'm heading to a tournament in St. Lawrence in 2 weeks, and those shallow water smallmouth, I'm hearing already some of the guys that have, you know, samples have been drawing those fish in from a long ways out to the sound and just crushing that smaller one. The smaller one's a little more aggressive side-to-side action. The larger one I tend to use for the largemouths. So.
Yeah, well, that's great. Well, again, I really do appreciate the time. I know it's only been a little bit of time, but you guys need to go to AmericanBoatWorks.com, baitworks.com, and check it out, or you can go to their social media stuff. They've got is the 5 minute video on the YouTube page, or is there on the Facebook page?
It's on our YouTube and on Facebook. So there's a 2 minute one and a 5 minute one. The 5 minute one goes into details of how to rig the bait, what rods you use, lines. All the different retrieves are outlined there as well. So it's a good, nice instructional piece.
Any other new lures that Freedom Tackle was coming out with this year?
Yeah, we're just uploading a video tonight. We're doing a fixed jig line.
Okay.
So we got the FT jig series, so a grass jig, structure jig, swim jig, and football jig. Those will be available this fall, probably September, October timeframe. So you'll see more coming out from that and a couple of little terminal tackle pieces that we're bringing out as well.
I'd love to have you, when those are about to go live, if you'd like to come back on here and do another interview, I'd love to do an interview and talk about that if you're interested.
Absolutely.
Excellent. Well, everyone, go to AmericanBaitWorks.com. It's on this page. You can see it right there. I did a little graphic for Tom, so go to his page. Go check him out. Go check out. I'll put it up there again. It's the Mischief Minnow. It is by far one of the most interesting lures I've seen this year at iCast. That's the God's honest truth. It's really impressive. I'm really excited to see it. I can't wait to fish it. I love the sound of it.
It's its own category. There's nothing like it on the market. You always hear that a lot in fishing, but really there isn't anything like this bait right now.
So. Well, you want to know what the problem is? Innovation in the industry just doesn't happen a lot. That's what's cool about what you guys have done here. This doesn't really copy anybody, but still works and can catch fish. And there's just too many people that just find a bait and knock it off, and that makes me mental. So it's great to see a company putting it together and doing it right. So congratulations on that. And it really does look like a fantastic lure. So I'm really excited for y'all.
We appreciate it.
Okay. Well, everyone go check out the social media. Check them out. They'll be available here soon. Tom, I appreciate the time, and we'll talk to you soon.
All right. Take care.
Thank you.
Thank you.